Hi, hello, and welcome to my channel. If you are new here, welcome. If you're a returning Titan, welcome on back for yet another video. I truly appreciate you guys being here for every upload. If you wouldn't mind hitting the like button, it really does help my channel grow. It really does help other people to be able to see this video. And I'm not sure how many people are going to be covering this update. So with that being said, I would love and appreciate it if you could just hit the thumbs up. So today's case, what we're going to be talking about is Debbie Collier. And if you are not familiar with the case, I do have other videos under the playlist, but I'm going to give you a timeline on what kind of happened with Debbie and her final moments. And you know, what led investigators to determine her cause of death the way that they did. So on Friday, September the 9th of 2022, Collier left her home in Athens, Georgia for the last time in her rented SUV. Saturday, September 10th, she was pictured on CCTV visiting a Family Dollar store in Clayton, Georgia, wearing a blue skirt and replica University of Georgia football jersey. She purchased a rain poncho, reusable tote bag, refillable torch lighter, a 7.5 foot by 9.5 foot tarpaulin, and paper towels. So she had some tarp, paper towels, torch lighter, reusable tote bag, and a rain poncho. She bought all of those items before she left the store at 3:09. After another 10 minutes in her vehicle, you can see from there is CCTV footage on the outside of the Family Dollar as well. You can see her in her vehicle for 10 minutes, and then she drives off, heading south along Georgia State Route 115. Also on the same date, Collier was reported missing by Amanda, her daughter, and her daughter's name is Amanda Bearden. Collier had earlier sent her daughter a Venmo payment of $2,300. $2,385 if you want to be exact, and instructions on where to find the house key. She noted that they're not going to let me go. I love you. Sunday, September the 11th, the day after this happened, police tracked the Sirius XM signal from Collier's rented vehicle to the U.S. Route 441. The nearby Chattahoochee National Forest was searched and Collier's body was found by a police dog. Initially, the incident was treated as a possible kidnapping and homicide, according to the police. And then Friday, September 30th, so we kind of jump from the 11th to the 30th, investigators hold their first press conference on the case with lead investigator George Casson and Habersham County Sheriff's Chief Deputy Murray Kogod giving an update on the investigation. Kogod said Collier had been the victim of a targeted killing. There is nothing that has come from the investigation that would support the theory that either this was a random act of violence or that there is a killer in the area. At this time, the investigation is leading us to the proposition that Ms. Collier's death was personal and targeted. So remember that. On Thursday, November 17th, we went a little bit further again. Local media outlet Now Habersham and the New York Post report the coroner's verdict naming that Collier died by suicide. So this Friday, September 30th, we're hearing this is targeted, this is personal, and then all of a sudden it's a suicide. So that kind of brings us where we are today. And this is what I wanted to show you on this live here. Let me just get to the right tab. And let me see if it'll let me make it a little bigger for you guys. That way, if you want to read along, you're able to. But I don't know if it will. There we go. Okay, it helped a little bit. And if I put me down here, maybe that'll help even more. So we'll go ahead and get right into this article here. This is the autopsy report has now come out. So this is what this is going to go over. It says at the top, Debbie Collier's autopsy reveals burns to 80% of her body. No explanation of suicide. This comes from the Daily Post and it's from February the 22nd, which is today, the day that I'm filming this. It actually came out about an hour ago. So if you guys haven't subscribed to the channel yet and you do love true crime, please do subscribe. We talk all true crime cases, old cases, new cases, perplexing cases, all the cases. Right now, we're really hitting hard on the Alec Murdoch trial and the Idaho 4, but we always come back to, you know, like Miss Debbie Collier case. If something comes up, we'll always be back to, you know, give you guys an explanation or a video on it. So if that's something that you might be interested in, please just hit the subscribe button. Georgia office worker Debbie Collier's body was 80% burned when she was found in a ravine 60 miles from her home, according to her autopsy report. The report done by the Georgia Bureau of Investigation, which is the GBI, and obtained by the Post through a public records request, raises more questions about Collier's shocking death, which was ultimately ruled a suicide, despite a months-long homicide investigation. Collier, a doting mother of two adult children, was reported missing on September 10th after she sent her daughter Amanda a Venmo payment for $2,385 with a chilling message saying, "They are not going to let me go. Love you." She was found dead in a ravine the next day in a wooded area of Royal Habersham County, more than an hour north of her Athens, Georgia home. Officials quickly opened a murder investigation that bore no results for months. Before police initially said Collier had charring to her stomach, but the autopsy reveals her burns were far more extensive, describing second and third degree burns involving 80% of the total body surface area. That is a lot more than what we were given before. The report says Collier died from inhalation of superheated gases, thermal injuries, and a hydrocodone intoxication. Collier often took the painkiller hydrocodone as prescribed by a doctor due to a prolonged back injury. If you're not sure what hydrocodone is, it's the same thing as Vicodin. It's just it's the medical name. Autopsy examination revealed thermal injuries of the external body surface and of the tracheal mucosa. It's the windpipe. No deposited soot in the airway. So there was no, mucus in the windpipe, no dispositive soot in the airway, and no significant elevation of blood carbohemoglobin. Sorry, guys. The report, which notes that no other significant injuries were noted. So they're saying right there in that sentence that she had no soot in her lungs. Her air pipe, her windpipe seem to be fine. Trachea, airways are all smooth. And it says, no other significant injuries were noted. These findings may be due to a sudden intense flash fire as well as an outdoor environment of the fire, the GBI wrote. Officials noted that a melted gas can be found near the burn site, perhaps the source of the flash fire, but did not explain the other circumstances, including that Collier was naked when discovered and why she was slightly downhill from the fire, gripping the base of a small tree with her right hand. And if you've been with me for any of the lives or any of the videos that we've done over Debbie Collier, she looks like a modest lady. I don't see her taking her clothing off if she was going to unalive herself. Why do that? Medical examiners, and if you know why people do those things, let me know in the comment section below. Please do. Medical examiners said Collier was discovered with third-degree burns to her face, charred portions of her scalp, and charred leathery skin throughout her body. Autopsy report also doesn't explain how the death was ruled a suicide beyond a quick line that states investigation by law enforcement revealed circumstances consistent with a self-intentioned act and that she was alone at the time of the incident. Georgia police described Collier's death in late September as personal and targeted, but never publicly named any suspects. The suicide ruling shocked those following the case and even some family members. Police also never explained Collier's Venmo message to her daughter, which caught the attention of the nation when revealed, or why she stopped at the Family Dollar store and bought a poncho, a refillable torch lighter, paper towels, a tarpaulin, and a tote bag on the day she disappeared. Collier, 59, worked for a local real estate agency in Athens and lived with her husband, Steve, in a small yellow home on the edge of town. Police were able to find her by tracking her rented vehicle's Sirius XM satellite radio, which led them to the US 441 near Victory Home Lane. Her body was discovered about a quarter mile into the woods. A neighbor told the Post in September that she heard a commotion coming from Collier's home the night before she vanished and that the family frequently engaged in screaming and fighting. Her daughter Amanda had only returned to town with her boyfriend, amateur MMA fighter Andrew Guidridge, a few days before her death. Guidridge told the Post in September that he and his girlfriend were being treated like suspects in the case, but the couple was ultimately cleared of any involvement by police, as was her husband, who was seen on video at the time of her disappearance working parking cars at a University of Georgia Bulldogs game. So that is what we have in the new, what we've got for Debbie Collier right now. Let me see something just really quick, guys, before I get off this video, just to make sure we didn't forget anything else. Let me see. I'm going to go ahead and read this next one to you because this one just came out today. So I'm sorry, the first one came out on the 20th. This one came out today. Famed pathologist Dr. Baden believes Debbie Collier's autopsy implies murder. Famed forensic pathologist Dr. Michael Baden believes that Georgia mom Debbie Collier was likely murdered and didn't kill herself as authorities claim. The former New York chief medical examiner said Collier's autopsy raises significant questions about how law enforcement came to believe she died by suicide, namely because the report notes she inhaled no soot or carbon monoxide. From a forensic point of view, that would indicate that she was dead before the fire started, Baden told the Post, saying soot and carbon monoxide are present 99% of the time when people die in a fire, especially self-immolation. The autopsy report obtained by the Post and provided to Baden for review claims Collier died from inhalation of superheated gases, thermal injuries, and a hydrocodone intoxication, and speculates she died in a flash fire due to the presence of a nearby gas can. Collier was reported missing on September 10th after she sent her daughter Amanda a Venmo payment for the $23.85 with a chilling message, "They're not going to let me go. Love you." Her naked and badly burned body, her remains were found in the woods 60 miles north of her home later that day. It would have been severely windy to blow away any carbon monoxide, Baden said, which is unlikely given the densely wooded area of Royal Hammersham County where she was found. I think the medical examiner doesn't understand what forensic pathology is, he equipped to the Post. While Biden said the levels of hydrocodone in Collier's system were higher than a therapeutic dose, it is impossible to tell what her tolerance for the drug was given that she had been prescribed the medication for a prolonged back injury. Citing her toxicology report, Biden said about a little less than half of the people would die from those levels. But if she did die of an overdose, the question of how the fire started remains, he said. And then her cause of death should be labeled hydrocodone overdose with post-mortem fire injuries. It makes it more confusing, he said in the toxicology report. The forensic pathologist who was hired by the families of George Floyd, Michael Brown, and Jeffrey Epstein to do private autopsies and appear in the show Autopsy said the fact that Collier was apparently found naked makes him further question the suicide conclusion. "You'll usually need clothing to set yourself on fire," he said. Early in the investigation, police said she was naked when discovered, while the autopsy notes that there were charred remnants of clothing presented in the distribution of the lower torso. Police say Collier was alone in the woods when she killed herself, but haven't provided any proof for the claim. If she died before the fire, as Baden believes, it would imply there was at least one other person there with her. The medical examiner for the Georgia Bureau investigation admit they do not come to the conclusion that Collier killed herself by themselves, writing in the autopsy report that an investigation by law enforcement revealed circumstances consistent with a self-intentioned act. "That means the police told me it was suicide. We're not just rubber stamps for the police, but some people think we are," Baden said, a forensic pathologist. Collier, 59, worked for a local real estate agency in Athens, Georgia, where she lived with her husband, Steve, in a small yellow home in the edge of town. Police immediately opened a murder investigation into her death following the discovery of her remains and at one point described her killing as personal and targeted. Cute little house. After 2 months of investigating, the Habersham County Sheriffs and FBI were never able to name a suspect, and her death was declared a suicide in November. Usually the GBI is much better than most, Baden said. I'm kind of upset that they could call this kind of case a suicide, especially with her being found naked. That's outrageous. So with those two articles being out there now for your little ears to hear, let me know what you guys think about this case. Do you think that this was an accident, a flash fire, and it was unintentional? Or do you think she did this to herself? Or do you think someone did this to her? It's going to be kind of hard to take drugs to overdose and then catch yourself on fire. It's just a little hard for me to believe. So let me know what you guys think in the comments below. I'd love to know, because you know I always love to hear from my Titans. If you haven't yet subscribed to the channel, please do. I'm trying to meet my goal of getting, what is it? We have a couple little goals going. So let's see. New goal is I'm trying to get to 6,500 little Titans by the end of this week. I think we can do it. We're already at 6,453. And I really appreciate you guys so much for sticking around with me. Love you guys so much. And I'll see you guys all in the next video. Bye.